Yeah, a lot of things to talk about today, but we want to start with the state capitol today. The Utah legislature focused part of their time on campus safety. As you know, the state has seen several incidents on campuses over the last couple of years, including the murder of Lauren McCluskey.
Well, Lad Egan tells us what measures they're looking at to make these college campuses safer.
I'm here at the Utah State Capitol. I'm joined now with Senator Jani Iwamoto. Thank you, Senator, for being with us today. The reason we're talking today is that you have been a supporter of campus safety, crafting legislation. And tell me what we're looking at this year, because we know you have a new bill that looks to amend our campus safety laws.
Yes. It's kind of a offspring of the first bill, because when we were doing the first bill, we saw that there were some questions about campus police and law enforcement and such. So after the session was over, we just met. I started meeting with different groups, campus police, law enforcement, victims advocates and students, and emergency management, just trying to find out what was working and what was not. And through that, we've came to some ideas as far as, do they share the same records? Do they have the same dispatch and things like that? Are they communicating so that there's seamless boundaries for a victim to know, and also for law enforcement? Because we know that crimes don't, boundaries don't just end at the school line.
Especially some of our campuses that we think of as kind of commuter campuses, or where lots of students aren't living there. And as you talk about that, I'm reminded of the Lauren McCluskey case, that she made calls to Salt Lake City police but was referred back to campus. And so you have various jurisdictions, and do some want to do away with campus police?
Well, there was that talk, and that's why when I studied this more this summer with stakeholders, it didn't seem like one size fit all, because sometimes it's working in one campus and sometimes something else. And campus police do other work too. And so I wanted to study it more, because we didn't want to just try to dictate another solution that may come up with problems. And that's what we learned from, you know, this summer.
And what do you see coming out of this, or what's the timeline for coming up with what solutions you want to have?
Well, we kind of put it on a timeline that we report in November, at the November, the last interim, by then. And we have some kind of report or things that we've done with stakeholders. They're the experts, and I wanted to see what solutions, if any, we could find. So maybe there would be a bill we end up with, or maybe we decide that there isn't, or we just, you know, it's going to be up to this group to look at different areas.
And maybe just one final quick question. Someone who maybe hasn't followed this, what would you say, since the death of Lauren McCluskey to now, you know, it's been a year and 4 months or so, have we made improvements?
Well, I think that there have been improvements, but until you really change the culture, you know, in a police office, for instance, or a campus police, or anywhere, until we really grasp that culture and know that things have changed, we don't want to just do superficial changes. We want real changes. And I think in this bill, we've talked to the institutions of higher ed also, and the technical college representatives, and they want to make real change too. So there's a lot of things you can do to do things in safety, and I think a lot of steps have been made, but this is a serious issue that's not just in Utah but across the nation, and so we want to try to get it right. And that's the beauty of last year's bill too. One of the important things was that we look backwards and forwards every year, and we always try to keep ahead and look back at what worked and didn't and move ahead each year. And that's something that's in that bill too.
Interesting. So an initiative that truly will never be done.
It's always, because when we Like I said, each campus is like a city, and number one is public safety, and we want our children to just not have to worry, and as parents, worry about the safety constantly. I mean, it always is a concern, but we want them to enjoy college for what it is and make connections and have a good time. But we also want victims, or if we can avoid victims, but if there are victims, that we want them to know exactly what to do, and not, you know, it's hard enough in regular times know what to do, but when you're under the stress of something that has happened, domestic violence, sexual assault, or whatever, we want them to know where to go and where to get help as soon as possible.
Absolutely. Thank you, Senator Jani Iwamoto, for joining us here on KSL Plus. We'll send it back to you.
All right. Thanks, Lad. Bringing us the entire interview
right
here on KSL Plus.
Always good.